Hello, this is April in Red. In this video, we'll be showing you the completion of the 2-foot-tall poured aircrete wall, which is the bottom portion of our 27 by 36 garden enclosure. This is our part 3 video, so be sure to check out our earlier videos. We'll do a final video once the garden fence is completed. We'll be pouring and removing the forms on the 36-foot section, trying out some aircrete mixes with fiberglass and basalt fiber reinforcements, and the girls and I plaster one section of the garden wall.
Well, we finished up the forms and we're getting ready to pour the last section of the garden wall. It's the long section along the long side. And we're going to be really careful as we're doing this. The last section that we poured, you know, it turned out okay, but the aircrete, even though it didn't settle a lot, it had a lot of bubbles in it and it didn't seem super strong. And so we didn't feel like it was quite right. And so we're going to try to be really careful and focus on the parameters, focus on controlling variables, and see if we can't get a better, you know, a better mix to put into this wall. So that's what we're focusing on this time. We've had a nice fall here, and so we've had some nice working conditions. Outdoor temperatures have been between in the 70s or low 80s during the day, so good conditions to pour aircrete. And here we are, we're just kind of mixing and pouring in some of the test sample batches that we showed in our previous video. So working on that here, one thing I'd like to mention about the wall that we're making, pretty, you know, good sized, it's 5 inches or about 5.5 inches thick and 2 feet tall. You know, aircrete is really light, and so this wall is also not on any kind of a, you know, big footer. It's just, you know, poured onto a virgin compacted soil. So it would probably tip over fairly easily if we didn't have these T-posts that we've, you know, pounded into the ground. And so they kind of act as anchors to keep the wall from, you know, being knocked over. And so I'm really glad we made it that way because aircrete's really light and I think that'll work out really well.
Of course, here we realize that aircrete isn't the ideal material to make a garden wall out of. It was just a convenient way for us to use the excess material we had from testing and also to become familiar with the product and kind of its properties and characteristics, and to help us decide whether we want to build a house out of it.
We've been really careful as we mix these batches to try to do everything right and to try to, you know, just take care and make sure it was all done properly so that we could try to come out with a good product here, a reliable, consistent product. But as you can see here, we're already seeing settlement. It's already starting to drop, and we decided to try it again another day. We waited a few days to try again, mostly because we needed our new Portland to come in, the type 1-2. They were out originally, and so we had to wait to get some in. So that's finally in, and we're making some more batches here. We decided to go with half batches, because we had trouble with the full batches. We just couldn't seem to get them mixed in enough. As I was scooping it out of the barrel with 5-gallon buckets, the last bucket at the bottom was much heavier than the first bucket I took out, which, you know, tells us that we're not getting good mixture from top to bottom of the barrel. And so we thought, well, we'll try to do half batches because it's easier to mix and maybe we'll get a better result, at least for testing. And so that's kind of what we're doing here, is doing some half batches for testing and then trying to fill up the wall some more. After making the samples, we did make one more full batch just to try to finish up filling this section of the wall, and it didn't turn out well. Unfortunately, it was really, really bubbly, but we went ahead and put it in and smoothed it off and decided we would try again once we reset the forms for the last section of the wall. We did end up seeing some settlement on, you know, our batches here too, unfortunately. Both the wall settled some and our test samples settled some as well. There's always a fair amount of cleanup anytime you work with, you know, any kind of cement or concrete, and it usually takes us 15 to 30 minutes to get everything washed up and cleaned out and ready to go. And so here we are moving on to, or trying to get ready to move on to the next section of the wall. We've let this section we just completed cure for the right amount of time, and we're taking the forms off. We've been leaving the forms on and letting them cure for about a week, mostly due to the colder temperatures that we're seeing at night. We feel like kind of leaving those forms on helps with the temperature, and it also keeps it wet. And so leave it on for about a week, and then move on to the next one. These actually looked okay once we took the forms off, even though we had some trouble with the mixes. I mean, it looks just fine. April did have to fill in a low spot along the top with some just concrete that she mixed because it had settled, you know, significantly an inch or two there. And so she just filled that in by hand. And then here's where I'm getting ready to move the form over for that last section. So I got it all moved over here, getting it kind of clamped onto the wall and just getting it kind of set up and tight so we can start pouring the very last section of the wall. We're getting ready to pour the last section of the wall here, and we haven't been real happy with the aircrete that we've been making lately, and so we're kind of taking extra pains this time to make sure everything is right. So we're double checking the water to make sure it's, you know, very soft. We're double checking our foam solution. So that is one problem that we thought we may have had, was that the Drexel wasn't being mixed properly, or maybe it wasn't at the right, you know, temperature. It was too cold. And so we took great pains to make sure the Drexel was mixed absolutely correctly, and we were using it at room temperature when we used it. And so we're just trying to really nail down all the variables and double check everything to make sure we're not doing anything wrong, because we're not having much luck. And so here we are, you know, going at it again, you know, resetting everything to see if we can make some more batches. And we're making some batches here actually that use fiber additives. Kind of just in our experience lately, not being able to make the strongest aircrete, it's got us thinking, well, is there anything we can add to it that would strengthen it? You know, we've tried several things that didn't seem to work too good. And so we started looking into other alternatives. We got some recommendations that we should, you know, try using some kind of a fiber additive, and particularly fiberglass fibers and basalt fibers. And so we decided to try that here and see if adding those would add a significant amount of strength to our mixtures and keep them from the micro cracking and the kind of issues that aircrete could have. And so we bought some fibers, some basalt fibers and some fiberglass fibers that we're using in these test samples. Here we're using 2 ounces of fiberglass or basalt per half batch. So that's about a, you know, quarter pound per full batch ratio. And so they didn't turn out great. They were really bubbly as I was pouring them in. They looked great in the barrel, but when I scooped them out with a 5-gallon bucket, they got bubbly. And here you can see they didn't fall as we're taking them out. You know, they kept their height, and they actually looked fine taking them out, but we decided to redo them again the next day just because they were so bubbly going into the form. So here we are the next day, pouring our next round of samples in again, and had the same problem. Pretty bubbly going into the form, looked great in the barrel. In these batches, we did both basalt because that's what we were most interested in, and we used the same quarter pound of basalt fiber per full batch ratio in one, and doubled that for the next batch just to see if, you know, that would somehow help. Also, you can see that we have these set up in our well house, and the reason that is because we keep it warm in our well house. Our well house is insulated, and plus we have a tiny little heater out there, and so we can basically guarantee that these don't get down below freezing. So we just wanted to isolate that variable too, to make sure we had great samples for testing. Once we finished up our fiber test samples, we needed about, you know, almost a full batch to fill up the wall. And so we decided to go ahead and try something new also. Because we're having trouble mixing the heavier stuff at the bottom, getting it up to the top of the barrel, we decided to try the 6 gallons of water ratio instead of the 5 in a full mix, and to see if that would help, see if that would make a lighter mix and make it easier to get that distribution of concrete even.
So here we are getting ready to apply a coat of plaster to the first section of the wall. First, my daughter and I went over the wall with a coarse rasp. Then we cleaned up the base of the wall. We had to chip off pieces of chunks of aircrete and clear the dirt away. After sanding the wall down and cleaning around the base of the wall, we wet it down with the garden hose. We have heard that plaster will not stick well if the surface is dry. To make the plaster, we used 1/2 gallon of bonding agent, 1/2 gallon of water, 2 gallons of Portland cement, and 1 cup of fiberglass fibers. As you can see here, we combined all of the ingredients into a 5-gallon bucket and then mixed it up with a drill. After mixing it well, we divided it into containers and went to work smearing it on the walls. I watched a few quick videos, but none of us had any experience with applying plaster, and we didn't have the ideal tools for the job, but it actually went pretty well.
Girls are professionals!
The girls said it was like icing a big cake. After putting a thin layer on the wall, we applied some of the fabric that we had left over from doing our leach field. It's like a thin landscape fabric. I don't know what it's made out of or how long it's going to last, but since we had it, we decided to give it a try. We soaked it in a bucket, then smoothed it down and coated it in plaster. The outside and the top of the wall have the fabric, but we didn't put it on the whole inside of the wall. The plaster filled in the holes nicely and seemed to add a lot of strength and stability to the wall. Unfortunately, our temperatures are getting down into the low 20s, so we may need to wait until spring to finish the plaster, or there may be some kind of accelerant we could add to the plaster, but I haven't looked into that yet. As you can see here, it's going pretty good. We used a spray bottle and a concrete float to help smooth it out. Here we're working on the second side of the wall. The fabric wrapped around the top and then came down about 6 inches on this side. We decided to just go ahead and fill in this other side of the wall just with the plaster. The plaster does have fiberglass fibers in it, which should give it some strength and crack resistance. Overall, the wall seemed to turn out pretty nice. We covered it well with plastic and tarps and let it cure for a few days.
Well, we finally finished up the aircrete section of the garden wall, and we're ready to remove the forms from the last section here. And so we're peeling those off, and it sure is satisfying to see those come off. Pulling this last section off here, and it looks pretty good. We did notice a couple sections where it's kind of white and powdery, and we think that may have been caused by it freezing there. We've had some really cold nights, and so that's part of the problem, but it was just on the surface, and the rest of it felt solid, so I think we're good there. Well, it's satisfying to finally be done with this. We're done with these forms. We've moved them all around the edges, used them 4 or 5 times here, but finally done with them. And so I'm disassembling them here and kind of save any of the wood that I can for use on another project. Put it in our pile over on the side and kind of clean up the garden area and get ready for the next thing. As I was taking these forms apart, I had to be really careful not to hurt the lizards. And it turned out, between the plastic layer and the wood, lizards had gotten in there and apparently liked living in there or something, because when we pulled these forms off, there was just tons of these cute little lizards in there. And we love all these little animals out here, so we really try hard not to hurt them. And so took care to let them get warmed up in the sun and then kind of move off and back into nature before we finished up with the disassembly. Well, it's satisfying to finish up this garden wall. Overall, it's turned out well, and I think it'll be, a great garden wall for us.
Thank you so much for joining us. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and also be sure to check out our other videos. We have lots of videos on aircrete and also the start of our home build.